Hey folks, Matt from RightOfTheImage.com. Got an interesting question here from Muhammad on the email. He says, hey sir, first of all, I loved your videos. They helped me a lot. And one thing I want to know, I'm just going to start my photography. I want to buy my gear, a DSLR and a lens. I want to step directly in kind of a professional photography. Which brand should I buy, or which camera, Canon or Nikon, and which lens? I want to use for weddings, indoor, outdoor, and portrait photography. My budget is about $2,000. I will be awaiting your response. Please give me good advice for choosing best gear. Thank you. Best regards. Well, thanks for your question, Muhammad. It's a good question. It's a bit of a loaded question because both camps or various camps are going to have different feelings on this. I'm just going to answer the question based upon what I would do. And I've thought about this many times. If I was to get back into doing weddings and events and portraits today, full time, like I used to, and I, without question, know what I would do for the best value oriented, the best bang for the buck for price, I would get a Nikon D610. It is one of the best performing full frame 24 megapixel sensors out there. There's very few cameras that beat it or even could beat it. It performs very well. It's a very good high ISO camera. It has a very decent autofocus system. Not the best autofocus system out there, but still a very competent autofocus system. And I'd be perfectly happy to use it for weddings, indoor and outdoor, and portrait photography. It won't let you down. And I would pair that with a 24-120 f4 VR from Nikon. Love that lens. Very good lens. Constant aperture f4. Great zoom range. That's why I would take that over a 2.8 zoom like the 17-50, which is a very good lens from Nikon. But I would rather have the 17-50. I'm thinking crop sensor. The 24-70 from Nikon. I would take the 24-120 over it because I would rather have the f4 but the extra range than have the limited range of the 24-70 at f2.8. With the D610 and its amazing high ISO abilities and great flash system, I'd be perfectly happy shooting that as my standard zoom, the 24-120 f4 VR, with probably an 85 f1.8. I say probably because I would always keep probably my, I have a 50mm f1.4D in the bag, and that's what would stay in the bag because for price, I got it for a sweet deal. It works great, works on the D610, gives me a really fast 50, but I would like to have that 85 f1.8G in the bag as well because it's a very good portrait lens. It's a very good lens for getting a little more reach at weddings. You may want to add, a lot of people like to shoot with a 70-200 f2.8. It's a main lens for most people. But I've gotten away from using that, and I did get away from using that. I liked a lighter, simpler kit in the last years of my wedding shooting and my event shooting and portrait shooting, and I found that a good standard zoom, like the 24-120 f4 VR, I could probably shoot the entire wedding without even the fast lens, but I like to have that 85 f1.8G to get some portrait stuff, to get some stuff in low light at the end of the night from a distance, and just to have that low light ability. So that made a great combination for me. Those two lenses, I could shoot everything I wanted to and not feel like I was really leaving anything out or anything like that, and be and feel very comfortable with the coverage I was doing. That's what I would do. If you were really leaning towards Canon, you could probably get either the original 60 or the 62. Not quite as good a camera as the D610 for ultimate image quality, but still very capable. Wouldn't have a problem with that if you wanted the Canon system. And then I'd do something similar. I would get the 24-105 f4L lens from Canon, and I would throw in the 85 f1.8 lens from Canon. So I'd do essentially the same lenses, just the comparable body. I prefer the Nikon. I prefer that Nikon body, the D610, and I prefer those lenses. If you're concerned about having a top-of-the-line autofocus system, you want something a little bit faster, you could upgrade to the D750 for very little upgrade, although I still feel the 610 is the best bang for the buck at an amazing price for an amazing performing full-frame camera. And that's the route I would go. So that's what I would do. And that's my options. If you were really gung-ho to go Canon instead, I would go the Nikon, but I wouldn't have a problem with you doing the Canon route with either of the 6Ds. And what would you guys do, though? Do you agree with me and what I would choose? What would you do, something different? What would you do and why? Let us know what you would choose for that setup for weddings, indoor and outdoor, and portraits, and why. Why would you choose it? What cameras and what lenses? Let's help out Muhammad. Thanks for your question. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.